today's product test is the OBD2 slot reader, code reader by Launch, which apparently is starting to get pretty popular as a alternative for the units like the Snap-ons that cost $3,000, $4,000 and hundreds to upgrade the software. And well, this one is also internet upgradable. Now it's not compatible with Teslas. Actually, there are no readers except Tesla's own proprietary and not public software for Tesla. So we are going to be testing this on a Lincoln MKT. Now, this supports all major brands, over 20 different manufacturers. Like I said, it's internet upgradable. It also comes with the protective bumper case right on it. You got to pay extra for that on Snap-on. It uses micro SDHC cards. This one's comes with a 4 gig, and you can get upgraded cards or just download the software updates from the internet. Uses a micro SD to connect to your computer, and you can print stats. I mean, there's a whole booklet on what you can do, but we're just going to do some previews and check out some of the basic functionality. So this thing stops beeping at me. Gosh, I forgot how annoying gasoline-powered cars are. Start that up. Okay, you can stop. Oh, really? The engine's on. Okay, you don't say. All right, that's annoying. Alright. Now, supports OBD2 functions, DTC repair help, display data stream, reads, resets codes, for an engine, it can even read SRS airbag codes. Now, one end you got the OBD slot, and the other end uses a serial connection. Plug that into the back here. And there we are. Now let's switch this into English. So obviously the gear would be set up. You know, select the first option and you can do your choice of language. So we're going to go back to English and escape. Units of measure. Well, we're in the U.S., so we're just going to switch that to imperial, although I would prefer metric. Diagnose. Let's see what we got here. Let's do OBD processing. Status. Yeah, it looks like stuff works. We don't have any codes. Let's go through. Just different options. Data stream. Let's see, what is that? View all items. Getting supported data stream. Loading. And there we go. Some interesting stuff. Now, this is live. There is only one fuel system, so it's clear. The engine is operating at 26% load. Oops. Current coolant temperature is 132 degrees. Well, obviously, I just started the SUV. Shows your fuel trim. Manifold pressure, engine RPM. Ahead of myself. Even has the timing advance for the cylinder. Cylinder number one is at about 17% or 17 degree timing advance, which it's only showing one cylinder, so I'm guessing that would be the timing advance for all cylinders. You got the air temperature, 77 degrees. That's about right. Oh! Engine just throttled down a bit. Let's see what we're at. That's our RPM. Yep, RPM's dropped. Engine's warming up. throttle positions at 13.3%. Now watch what happens when I see throttle position changes. You got the oxygen sensor. Now that's cool. Even shows us what our fuel level is. 93.7%. That's some neat information. I mean, it's showing just about everything. Even shows you what your catalytic converter temperature is. How about that? We got two of them. And that's it for the live data on this screen. Graphic items. Let's see what that says. There, and it'll even graph all the data. Load, temperatures. You can select all different things. It's backed up a bit. Freeze frame. Oh, does not have freeze frame. O2 sensor test. Nope, this vehicle does not support. So I guess if it does support, onboard monitoring. Oh, what do we got there? Catalyst monitor. Misfire monitor data. Pass. Pass. No misfires. Evap system test. Let's see. Evap system leak test passed. So that means the gas cap is on. Vehicle information. This is just for reference, since a lot of my viewers are Tesla owners. This is pretty much the only information you'll be able to get out of a Tesla, so don't waste your time. Read codes. No fault codes. Yeah, let's exit. Scan. Okay, we got Audi, Acura, Benz, BMW, Chrysler, Citroen, Dacia, Daewoo, Ford, Fiat, GM, Honda, Hyundai Infiniti, Jaguar, Isuzu, Kia, Lancia, Land Rover, Lexus, Mazda, Mini, Mitsubishi, Nissan, Opel, Peugeot, Porsche, Renault, Romeo, which is actually Alfa Romeo, Saab, Seat, Skoda, Mercedes, Sprinter, those are those neat diesel vans. Amazon's been using a lot of those for package delivery. Subaru, Suzuki, Scion, Toyota, Ford, Vauxhall, Volvo, and Volkswagen. So let's go up to Lincoln. Huh, Lincoln's not on the list? Huh. Well, I guess that function's not available. I haven't done a software update. I'm sure there's an update. In the guide, it actually includes on how to upgrade the software on your computer, including your key codes and so on and so forth. And it's also got a neat help function. Upgrade information. Visit mycar.x431.com/pad/ a whole lot of letters to upgrade. tool information, abbreviation. Let's check out settings. No, nothing else there. Oh, duh. What am I thinking? Lincoln is Ford. Automatically search. Please wait. Read fault data. No faults. Powertrain control module. No faults. We might have to try this on that Lincoln Navigator over there. I know that thing's always got problems. Veiled Uncle Dynamics Module. No faults. Looks like this is a rare Lincoln that's not having any trouble. What else did I miss? Let's try this monitoring again. Launch tech. This is just the neatest thing, though, right here. RPM limiter. Cool. So, all in all, it's a neat little device. Learning curve's extremely quick. And low cost. Check out, if you're looking to purchase, check out the purchase link below. Seems to be a rugged unit. Most of your Snap-ons are not going to come with the casing. And trust me, we dropped one at my old shop once, and even with the case on, my old Snap-on unit did not survive a 3-foot drop. So, review. Well, we didn't record anything. So, there it is. Now, the device does not require batteries, and it will shut off when it's disconnected. It operates, or it's powered off the vehicle. And then again, from USB when you plug it into your computer. So if you save any data from the computer, it's not lost when it's unplugged. It will just come back once it's plugged in to your computer. Let's just check out the product packaging real quick here. Card reader, VIII is a well-built comprehensive diagnosis instrument by launch. It's not only including full functionality of OBD2 and EOBD, but also support more functionality of four systems, engine, automatic transmission, anti-lock braking system, and airbag of certain models of cars, as read and reset code, multi-language data flow, picture display, storage, and playback of dynamic data flow, and able to provide special functions, engine oil light reset, reset brake lock, and correct steering angle sensor. Multi-language instructions, and that's the Chinese side. Shows you operation of the unit, how to update. So right off the bat, since it's been sitting in the package, chances are there's already a software update waiting for us. And there's multiple ways to update. You have to use the tool information to get your registration code. And I'm thinking we'll go inside and do that now. I'll ask you if you want to update. And there's more detailed instructions on their website. So if you're interested in purchasing, please see the details and descriptions box below the video. There's some more in the back. And which will take you to the Amazon page. So those of you still driving an ICE, servicing an ICE car or a diesel, this will be for you, and a heck of a lot cheaper than a Snap-on.